The parts of the oral cavity. Oral cavity is divided into two parts, vestibule and proper oral cavity. Vestibule is bounded anteriorly by lips and teeth and gums, and laterally it's bounded by cheeks, teeth and gums. So vestibule is everything, the space outside teeth and gums. Proper oral cavity. Anteriorly is bounded by teeth and gums. Laterally it's bounded by teeth and gums. Superiorly it's bounded by hard palate and soft palate. Inferiorly it's bounded by the oral floor, the diaphragm of the oral cavity. Posteriorly it doesn't have a wall, it has an opening which is called fauces or pharyngeal isthmus. Fauces is the opening which leads from the proper oral cavity into oral part of the pharynx. Superior wall of the proper oral cavity. Hard palate one more time and soft palate. Hard palate is made up of two bones, maxilla and palatine bone. Palatine processes of the maxilla fused together by means of median suture, and on the posterior side they articulate with the horizontal plates of the palatine bone. Here we have incisive canal, here two greater palatine canals and lesser palatine foramina. Hard palate is lined by mucosa. Soft palate is made up of five muscles, palatine aponeurosis, and all the muscles and aponeurosis are covered by mucosa from all the sides. Soft palate has transverse part and vertical part. Vertical part is called palatine velum. It hangs down vertically. The central part of the soft palate is called uvula. Fauces. Fauces is the opening bounded superiorly by palatine velum. Inferiorly it's bounded by the root of the tongue. Laterally it's bounded by two folds, palatoglossal. On the right and on the left side we have two palatoglossal arches. This is one of palatoglossal arches. Inferior wall of the proper oral cavity is oral diaphragm or oral floor. It's formed by suprachyoid muscles. The largest suprachyoid muscle is mylohyoid. Next to it, more superficially, is digastric muscle. And deep to mylohyoid, this is mylohyoid, and that one is geniohyoid muscle. Common action of suprachyoid muscles is to depress the mandible. So they open the oral cavity, and these muscles, their fascia, fat, skin, make oral diaphragm. Muscles of the tongue. Tongue is situated in the proper oral cavity, and the muscles of the tongue can be divided into two muscle groups. Proper muscles, intrinsic muscles of the tongue, and extrinsic muscles of the tongue. Intrinsic muscles are situated inside the tongue and they change shape of the tongue. Extrinsic muscles are attached to surrounding bones and they change position of the tongue. Which muscles we can see on this model? Intrinsic muscles. There are four intrinsic muscles. This is superior longitudinal muscle. This is transverse muscle, inferior longitudinal muscle, and vertical muscle. And we can see here one of extrinsic muscles. This is genioglossus. Genioglossus muscle originates from the mental spine. And just below the genioglossus, we can see again geniohyoid and mylohyoid. Other extrinsic muscles of the tongue we cannot see on this model. Which muscles? Hyoglossus muscle is not visible here, and styloglossus. Palatoglossus muscle is inside palatoglossal arch, and it belongs to the tongue and to the soft palate at the same time.